We have seen incredible 3D graphics in games, but do you know what's been quietly powering these visuals for decades?
Nope.
Chances are it's OpenGL. But what exactly is OpenGL? Well, according to Wikipedia, it is an API used for rendering 2D and 3D graphics. In simple terms, it's a tool that helps games and game engines like Godot, Unity and Unreal talk to your graphics card so they can draw things on your screen.
Interesting.
But how does it actually work? Let's have a quick look at it in this episode of the Engine Archive. Here's a graphic card, also known as GPU. Every phone, laptop or PC has a GPU. Without one, you wouldn't see anything on your screen. Now, if a program wants to draw something using the GPU, it first needs to tell the graphics card what to draw and where to draw it, and that requires coding. But here's the catch.
What is it?
Every GPU is different. Imagine having to write separate code for every GPU out there, so your program can run on all devices. Sounds exhausting, right? But back in early 2000s, that was a real problem. Developers had to write different, complex code for each type of hardware, which was both time-consuming and complicated. Not just for developers, but for gamers too. Gamers had to check if a game was compatible with their graphic card or not.
Those days were horrible. I remember them. I really do.
So to fix this, in 1992, OpenGL API was released by Silicon Graphics to interact with the GPU for rendering 2D and 3D graphics. So now, if a program wants to draw something using the GPU, it tells the OpenGL and it informs the GPU to do it. This way, developers can write their code once using the OpenGL API, and it will run on different systems without needing to change everything. Have a look at this impressive repo from Fugleman. He has made a simple Minecraft clone written in C using OpenGL shaders, and it's amazing. We can destroy a block, place a block, and roam around freely. Guess the size of this code? Just 5 MB. When I first discovered this, I was amazed. Like, how is it possible in C? So I researched a little and found out that we can use this graphics library framework in C to use OpenGL. And yep, the OpenGL API was also written in the C language. Here's a simple code that creates an RGB triangle. In simple words, we first clear the color buffer, then start drawing the triangle. Next, we define the color of each vertex and specify its position. Since a triangle has 3 vertices, we repeat this process 3 times. Finally, we end the drawing. If I run this, we get an RGB triangle. Since OpenGL is a cross-platform API, it is not limited to C or C++. For Java, we can use libraries like the lightweight Java game library. For Python, we can use PyOpenGL. For JavaScript, we can use WebGL. Now, OpenGL is powerful, but it's also low level. Writing a full game with only OpenGL would mean handling everything. Rendering, physics, input, sound, UI on your own. This is where game engines come in, and they are built on top of APIs like OpenGL, DirectX, Vulkan or Metal to make development way easier. You might be thinking, what is DirectX, Vulkan and Metal? These are also graphics rendering APIs like OpenGL. Vulkan is the successor to OpenGL. Since OpenGL is no longer in active development, everyone is slowly transitioning to Vulkan, which offers better performance, multi-threading, and lower-level GPU access. DirectX, on the other hand, is Microsoft's graphics API, designed specifically for Windows and Xbox. And Metal? That's Apple's graphics API, built for Apple devices. Different engines use different rendering APIs based on the platform. Unity supports DirectX, Vulkan, Metal, and OpenGL, depending on the OS. Unreal primarily uses DirectX on Windows and Vulkan or Metal elsewhere. Godot, once OpenGL based, is now shifting to Vulkan for better performance. Although newer APIs like Vulkan offer better performance and lower level control, OpenGL isn't disappearing anytime soon.
And why is that?
Many older devices still rely on it, and learning OpenGL gives you solid foundation of real-time rendering concepts. Some developers have even built their own game engines using OpenGL. So while OpenGL might not be the future of rendering, but it's the foundation on which that future is built. What do you think? Does understanding OpenGL still matter for today's game developers? Let me know your thoughts in the comments.